In this video, I'm going to show you how we can create a voting app using the MIT App Inventor. And this is the totally dynamic app. It means you can change the name and the images from the Firebase. So we are going to connect it. So let me just show you a step by step everything here. So first of all, we need to click on the new project. And my project name is Voting App New 2024. And OK. And here you can see our first screen. OK. Now we need to design this app. OK. Now, first of all, I'm going to use here the vertical arrangement. In the left side, you will see the layout. Just close the user interface, click on layout, and you can see the vertical arrangement. Just drag and drop it. And just make this to the height and width is fill parent, like this. Now, we need to use here one horizontal arrangement. So I'm going to use here the horizontal arrangement like this and make this width is fill parent, like this. You can make your height is also fill parent. Like this. So first of all, what I'm going to do, I'm going to design the first row here. Okay. So this is the horizontal arrangement. So we need to drag and drop here one image like this. And we need to use here one button where people can vote, but we need a name bottom of that image. How we can add it? So we need to again add one vertical arrangement under the horizontal arrangement. So click on the layouts and can see the horizontal. So we need to add the vertical arrangement here, this one. So just drag and drop vertical arrangement here, this one. Now we need to drag and drop images under this, and we need to drag and drop one label also to put the name like this. Now we have this button, we have this image, and we have that text. So for the image, what I'm going to do, I'm going to just make height and width is 200 pixel. Okay. To height and width both should be 200 pixel. Like this. Now for the name, I'm going to just here the name one, because this name going to be a dynamic. Okay. So we are going to fetch that name and images from the Firebase. So like this, make sure vertical arrangement, make this in a center, all the thing like this, and make the horizontal also all this thing are like in a center, and make sure the vertical that should be also in a center, all the things like this. Okay. Now what I'm going to do, click on that button and you can change that button width. So I'm going to make that width is like around 50%. And then I'm going to just make that text to something VOT vote like this. Make that round size to 20 like this and make that height. You can make height as like 20% or 30%. 20% is fine. 20%. Okay. Now we need to use here one voting count also. We need to use here again one more vertical arrangement. So we can see the layout, this, and this is the vertical arrangement. I'm gonna add here the images and label. Okay. So for that, first of all, what you need to do here, you just need to make all this thing in like you know, this one should be like fill parent to automatic, like this. So you have the image, that image. Okay. You can just change the font size to tablet size. So for the that button, I'm going to just make like, let's try to make this width is automatic. So I can see it like this here. Okay. Now I'm going to add here, click on user interface and drag and drop here one label like this. Okay. Now this is done. Now make sure that word arrangement should be also in a center like this. Okay. Now what I'm going to do here, I'm going to make that vertical arrangement is all the thing is fill parent, horizontal is width is fill parent, like this. Now make that tablet size to the font size like this. So this is our overall app design. Okay. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to design that button. Okay. So you can just change that background color to something like this. I'm going to use for the voting like this. Okay. And for this label, this is the count. So I'm going to make it here, the value is 0 for now, and make this font size 20, or make it 30 because it's a count. Okay. And now we have completed the one portion design, which means we'll use your one member image here. Here is a name. So you can make it font bold or like, you know, make it like 18 at least. Now what we need to do here, make sure we need to just copy and paste that whole horizontal arrangement and just control V, and we have two here. Done. Now, what we need to do here, I'm going to add one more horizontal arrangement here, okay, between this vertical arrangement. As you can see here, we have vertical arrangement and we have two horizontal arrangement. So I'm going to add one horizontal arrangement again, because I need to show the winners over here. So I'm going to add the horizontal arrangement like this, like here, and make that with this fill parent. And so let's add the label here, okay, like this, and add one image also here, like this, okay, and make this thing in a center like this, okay, and make sure that image should be the height and width is like, you know, 100 pixels. It's done, okay, and that text is like, you know, win or something, and make it at least 20, like this. You can change the background color of this also, so go to the custom, here the color plate, you can choose any color from here, okay, so let's suppose the purple, let's try, make sure we need to change that text color to the white, so it's look fine, like this, make it font bold, and that winner image will pick from that both members. Suppose this member have the 10 votes, but that member have the, you know, another member have the 9 votes, so automatically here you will see the one person, the winner one, in the first one's picture here, okay. So this is the overall design we have completed. That's the design, okay. You can change here a lot of things, like color you can change, the combinations. I'm going to add the vertical arrangement color should be like, you know, some lighter color. So light color is like this one. I'm going to add it here. But make sure all the, you know, arrangement, you need to make sure that background color should be none, like this. Okay. So like none for the all, like you can just add. Cool. So that's the overall design we have completed for our dynamic voting app. Now let's create a Firebase account. So first of all, open the firebase.google.com. Now we need to connect our Firebase database with our MIT App Inventor. So go to the console. You need to create an account, like you just need to log in with your Gmail account. And then we need to click on the create a project. Click on this. And your project name is suppose voting app 2024. And click on the continue. And click on the continue again. Select any account and create project. So here's the done. Let's click on the continue. Click on the build option in the left side. You'll see and can see the real-time database. Let's click on this. And now we need to here do one thing. We need to use here that URL. So let's create a, you know, database, real-time database. And you can see the create database. Click on that create database. And you just need to click on the continue option and just next and enable this. Make sure that we need to go to the rules option. And we need to enable that, you know, rule here from make it true like this and like this and make sure that publish. Go to the data option, copy that URL, go to the MIT App Inventor. In the left side, you will see here, just close it. You can see the experimental, just try and drop the Firebase DB here. And you can see the Firebase URL. We need to paste that URL here like this. Okay. Now we have successfully connected our Firebase, okay, Firebase, that database with our app. Now we need to store the value. It means the votings we need to store, and we need to fetch the person's name that, you know, the image. Let's suppose the Donald Trump, we need to fetch the image. We need to fetch the Kamala Harris image here. So in the next part, we will learn how we can do the block code to connect the Firebase with MIT App Inventor with this voting app. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any doubt, you can answer and comment. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye-bye. And we need to wait some second and it's loaded. You can see the Donald Trump and the Kamala Harris. Now you can vote. I can see the winner is nothing right now. Let me just try to vote for Kamala. So let's click on one. You can see the winner is Kamala Harris because Donald Trump has 0 votes right now. Let's try to put 1 vote here. You can see winner is no one. Let's try to put two votes here like this. You can vote like this, right? And you can vote now. Let's vote for the Kamala Harris, 3, 4, like this. Now all these value is saving in this database. As you can see here, the 4, Donald Trump, Kamala Harris, and I have used here the, you know, image URL to fetch the images to this image box. So we can change the name and the images using the Firebase. So we don't need to create multiple apps. We can use this app for multiple votings